Thanks, John. So, I am Dylan. I've got my teammates here with me, Alyssa, Anu, and Rohan. And we are here to kick off the MIMS Capstone presentations with our project, Augmented Reality for Visually Impaired People. Now, some of you may be thinking, augmented reality, isn't that what the kids these days use to catch their Pokemons with? Can that really be helpful for blind people? And we say yes, because augmented reality, at its core, is about taking digital information and placing it in the physical world. And in order to do that, these AR devices, whether it be a phone or a headset, are constantly scanning the environment. Now, for sighted people, the devices probably don't know anything they don't already because they can see the environment. But for blind and visually impaired people, these devices are picking up information that those people may not have access to. So that led us to the core of our idea. How can blind people use augmented reality to gain useful information about their environment? Now, I'm not going to linger on the process because we're about to run you through it, but I will just note that none of us up here are blind or visually impaired. And so that means that we knew we had to include blind and visually impaired people throughout the entire design process to make sure that we were designing with them and not designing at them. So now to talk about that process, I'll pass it to Rohan.
Thanks, Doug. We started with generative user research, actually interviewing disability experts, blind users, and accessibility evangelists. The first thing we learned was that technology needed to supplement the cane or guide dog. It was hard to hold a smartphone camera while also having a cane or a guide dog in the other hand. The next thing we went on to do was some more formative research. We met with advocacy groups at Lighthouse Labs and the National Federation for the Blind. It was clear that gathering semantic information from the environment was much more important than just wayfinding. We also learned to find the right balance of audio cues as well as speech, so that we wouldn't overwhelm the user's sense of hearing. Finally, we closely interacted with the Microsoft HoloLens team, as well as researchers at Berkeley and Caltech, who work at the cutting edge of AR. Our finding was that we need to focus on the 5-meter problem, such as the bus stop problem, and that AR was well suited to solve such problems. We also did some. We also looked into some existing solutions in the market. We believe that we are well situated to solve both obstacle navigation as well as text recognition without the need for external human intervention by leveraging AR and machine vision.
So next, I'm going to talk about our design and development process. But first, Rohan mentioned the 5-meter problem. And what is it? So we know that the cane and the dog are really insufficient to provide enough semantic information about their environment. And for navigation, you know, we typically use the GPS, but the GPS doesn't really get you exactly to where you need to go. And I think we've all experienced it in our daily lives. And for blind people, this is a classic example where they have a problem of finding the right bus stop. So if you're familiar with the UC Berkeley campus, you know that there might be multiple bus stops on the same street. And blind people can use the GPS to get there to around that location, but you know they're going to have a really tough time finding the specific bus stop. And this is really where we come in, and we want to propose a combination of obstacle stratification, text recognition, and sound design to solve this 5-meter problem. So first, we're going to watch a video of what it is from our prototype.
Obstacles on.
Obstacles on.
So what's happening here? So first, we use the spatial mapping capability of the HoloLens to map the environment. And this creates a three-dimensional map of the environment. And then we sonify the obstacles in that environment. And this is where we can kind of differentiate between the walls and the obstacles around the user. And then we have a final step where we're actually using sort of a process to really look at the obstacles that the user is looking at to prevent too much cognitive overload. Next, we have text recognition. Here's a video from our prototype.
Demo capture text 2.
Capturing image, analyzing.
text.
So what's happening here? We understand that getting semantic information from the environment is really important, and we want to use text recognition to do that. So when the user says capture text, we use the camera from the HoloLens to take a picture, we process it via the API, we instantiate a text beacon to sonify the text, that's the bing sound that you heard, and then we read that text aloud when the user commands it. The final step of our design is sound, and we recognize that very early on, the sound is going to be a very crucial part of the user experience. So people get very overwhelmed with too much sound around them. And we decided to use earcons, which for those of you that know is the audio version of icons. And we have different flavors of text, obstacles, and walls to really provide the user with the experience of getting information from text and obstacles and maybe like having the walls a little bit further.
Once we completed our development, we wanted to understand how effective is our device in terms of communicating the semantic information that's around it, and how can it help our users, especially blind users, in terms of navigating. So to do that, we conducted two rounds of user testing. Our first study was done with sighted individuals, and the main aim of the study was to perfect the design for our blind and visually impaired participants to really understand how is the device functioning, is it giving them the desired functionality or not. In the study two, we focused mainly on blind and visually impaired participants, and now the goal was to evaluate our hypothesis. So for user testing, as you can see in the picture, we created our own bus stops. We used a combination of chairs, poles, and cardboard signs to mimic a bus stop scenario. And this was conducted at Southland in UC Berkeley. In usability testing, we asked the participant to perform a few tasks. And we were mainly centered in terms of helping them understand four constructs. So one of them was object localization, the second one was text recognition, and the third one was blind direct navigation. So now we'll take you to one of the setups that we conducted, and we'll help you understand how our users interacted with our device. So in the next video, you will see one of our participants trying to localize the bus stop signs. Able to identify the directions of each of these bus stops. In the next task, we ask her to find a specific bus stop and help us identify where is that bus stop placed.
Capture text. Read text. That's the 52.
So as you saw, she was able to identify bus stop 52, which was assigned to her as a task. So most of our participants were able to identify the bus stops that they had in the surroundings and in turn navigate to a particular bus stop. In terms of the comments that we got from user testing, our participants said that they could tell the difference between 1, 2, and 3, which was really crucial for us in terms of evaluating the prototype. We also get a glimpse of what the participants wanted in the future testing. So one of the participants commented that I wish I could just ask you to find the picture rather than you capturing commands and then asking you to read it. So this helps us to understand not only where we are, but what we can do in the future. So we do understand that we had a good number of participants, so we tested on 7 blind participants, but we do understand because we tested in indoor environments and in controlled setting where we had control over noise and the amount of objects they had in the surroundings, it does not truly mimic the real world life bus stop scenario, and we may have to do further research to that.
So what's next for AR for VIPs? Well, in addition to additional features, we'd really love to explore opportunities for implementation. For example, in the same way that grocery stores sometimes purchase scooters for their mobility impaired customers, we could see them purchasing augmented reality devices for their visually impaired customers. But really, this is just the beginning. The power of augmented reality to allow blind people to navigate in unfamiliar environments with more confidence and more independence, we feel is really high. And in the future, we hope that our application will serve as a hope and an example of the many, many people we're sure that will use augmented reality to help people with disabilities for the days to come. Thanks very much.